Ride with the mob, alhamdulillah. Check you and me, and do your job. Earth is the name, the wallet did the chain. Turn off for the watch, ready plain Jane. He in bikini chain, rest in peace to my superior. Hermes, look up, feed a village in Liberia. TMZ, take it.
Welcome to the next episode of Advanced Fighter Pilot Training. Hope you like my new voice, it's still major pain. We had so far episodes about control settings, sectors, and enhancement and calibration guide. So now it's time for another episode, this time about tactics on the battlefield. Let's start with the fact that before the battle begins, we have 30 seconds to analyze the composition of the teams and the map. We can check the composition of the team by pressing the right mouse button on each player. If we see a list of options, such as adding to friends or reporting, it means that we are dealing with a player. If nothing is displayed, it means a game bot. You can also search for mods for the game showing bots. It is also important to plan the battle, especially as we fly in a flight, and as in this case, I decided with my friend's callsign Bobus that we split up, and he is flying on the bomber to take over the rocket base, and I'm flying a heavy fighter to the garrison, and then to the enemy's rocket base. Sometimes if you fly with two light fighters, and on the opposite side there is also a flight of light fighters, then you have to think about whether you should fly together to one sector, such as the airport. You should think carefully, and take into account what your plane is good at. It is also important to analyze the sectors. Remember about the key sectors on the map. In this battle there are two rocket bases. They are crucial because, as you know, they help to take over neighboring sectors. And as it is commonly known, the best way to win is to quickly take over sectors, most often, but not always. Sometimes you need to focus on specific players of the opposing team. It can also ensure victory. Here is a good example of how good players on attack plane should not be engaged. They seemingly seem like an easy target, but in the hands of an experienced player they are not defenseless. The goal of this episode is to increase your win percentage. For this matter, good tactics on the battlefield are important. You need to know where your aircraft will work best, which sectors are key on a given map. Equally important is situational awareness. It is nothing more than looking at the mini-map, so you know where you are the most needed when a dangerous enemy approaching. Also important is the specialization of the aircraft. Level of the crew training. Now, as you can see, the initial plan did not come out. The time when we are waiting to enter the battle should be used to analyze the situation, and we have decided here that after this fuck up, I will go to defend our missile base. So when it comes to defending sectors, you must not overdo it. In this case it is crucial and there are a lot of enemy planes flying there, so defense is of great importance, but you have to pay attention not to do something that we call overcommitment to the sector. If there are not many enemy planes or they fly individually, then despite the great temptation, we should fly and try to take over another sector. You have to take into account which planes fly into the sector. For example, light fighters are not able to take over sectors such as missile base or command center by themselves, not to mention about the factory. Take into account whether the player or bot enters a given sector. If the player also needs to check whether he is playing well or not, and he will not be able to take over the sector quickly. And again, this is part of your situational awareness. We have the weaker one in this battle, and he caught the fire nicely. Hehehehe. Night on fire will burn out. As you can see in this battle, I focus on defending the key sector and the Bobus has seized the next rocket base. This is the key to victory. These two rocket bases help us take over other sectors, and the flight of enemies, although good players do not keep up with taking over. If you're playing in flight, then it depends on the skill of your companion. If you play with a friend with similar skills or better, it has a huge impact on the percentage of victories, because you have a guarantee that in your team will be a good player. And in this game it happens quite often that there are two players per team, and if you fly with someone weaker and teach him to play, unfortunately you weaken your team. Nothing wrong with that, if, of course, you are not crazy about wins, as unfortunately the number of players has. So remember, if you can play flight, go for it. Discord communication is also important. You can exchange information, help each other. It was a very difficult game. A lot of effort. As you saw, I failed to shoot down the attack plane, only the enemy light fighter, which was of no such importance in this battle. For most of the battle, we managed to maintain sector advantage by maintaining two missile bases long enough. We go to the next battle. It is a battle with the same flight, but the sectors on the map are 5 garrisons. In such battles, light fighters work best. There are no strategic positions here. Remember about unlocking sectors. I often see someone shoot down a plane that could have been shot down a second or two later, and gain 60 points to take over the sector. The best way to capture garrisons when flying a fighter is to start from over 2000 meters and shoot down to heavy fighters, and then dive on light one. If you start at low altitude, unfortunately you risk very much that these two heavy fighters will come down on your head and make a smelly poop. This battle is only a race over garrisons flipping over, and occasionally there may be skirmishes over disputed sectors. This time I do not pay so much attention to a less significant opponent. I'm looking for a player on an attack plane who, of course, does a lot in this battle. In this battle, shooting players from the enemy flight is very important, because it allows you to take over more sectors. When they are not in the battle, you need to take advantage of such opportunities, and each enemy shot down in this battle has a significant impact on our victory. In such balanced duels, it often comes to squall line. You have the information in advance, so it is very important that you prepare yourself. If you fly low in a bomber, time to go a higher altitude. If in a fighter, you need to get the best position to attack a player of the opposite team in order to eliminate him the second after squall line. If you fly light fighters, it may be time to start flying together before the squall. Cover yourself. It is worth crashing before, if you have little HP. If of course you still have some games left, you need to think about it, whether you will need extra HP, and whether sometimes it is worth waiting for a long time to re-enter the battle. Here, in such a situation, I decided that it is worth taking the risk and completing the attack at all costs, especially that he is the best player of the opposite team, so kamikaze attacks are sometimes allowed. To sum up, battles with garrisons only are good for light fighters and multi-role fighters. Less maneuverable heavy fighters or bombers with 4 bombs especially have a bit more difficult job, because such battles are about taking over garrisons and occasionally going to a dogfight with enemy flight. Such clashes are not too complicated. You just have to take over the garrisons as soon as possible, and when the sectors are so close to each other, it is better to fly and take over the next one than to defend the garrison. Take into account unlocking the sector after 30 seconds. During this time you will already be over the next sector, and remember that an even fight always ends with a squall. And then if you are playing against 2 light fighters, it is worth joining before dogfight. Squall line is often the decisive moment. And let's move on to the next battle. We have an airfield in the middle of 2 garrisons and a key factory. We split up again, because the enemy flight has a similar layout, light fighter and attack plane. The plan is that the bomber flies to take over the factory and I with a light fighter will fight for the center of the map and other sectors. It is worth mentioning that dogfight is inevitable, and enemy fighter Swift and my MiG-15 are very similar in parameters. On this map, it is impossible to bypass the enemy and attack other sectors, as in the case of a battle with 5 garrisons, where I have not met Mr. Knight even once. Of course, at the beginning we take the closest sector, then we fly to the airbase in the center of the map, where we can expect, apart from defense planes, a large number of enemy planes. We start the initial fight. In this case we know that the opponent is a good player, so at the beginning we observe the situation. We make sure that we are not the first to enter the sector and let the opponent engage in the fight, then we attack. However, in this attack we make a mistake. It takes too long. The opponent sees incoming, and he uses the terrain nicely to cover himself and close the distance, and we decide to disengage, but it is too late, and we turn from hunter to victim. The situation starts to smell like French cheese. Let's save ourselves by maneuvers and sudden slowing down just above the ground. Our opponent did not notice it quite quickly and comes out in front of our plane. We are turning the situation around now. He has us at 6 o'clock. So now he is doing Forrest Gump stand, and he run away. Fierce fight, although we have lost too much time. For a while we disengage, and take advantage of the airport repair unit. This is situational awareness. Now we are back in the fight. And so we caught the knight with his pants down. The situation does not look very good on the map. The biggest problem is the factory, which should be recaptured immediately after it is taken over by the enemy. It is a part of situational awareness to keep an eye on it. We take over the sectors as soon as possible. After some time, Knight comes back. He wants to fight head on with the spear after the maneuver fight has failed. He probably wants a revenge, but not this time. The Knight returns next fight head on, and why not? The next attack head on could be avoided, and we can enter a maneuver fight, but we know the squall line is coming. So it's better to go head on with a small amount of HP, take some of the opponent's HP just before the squall, and then enter the fight ourselves with 100% HP. So we are back at 100%, but the knight is gone again. The bots have defeated him. XD. And this is how the battle ends. We are going for air domination, but unfortunately the factory was not captured on time, and adds 80 points, and the battle is up to 600. Unfortunately. Even our enemies are surprised. Hard truth is Bobus deliver fuck up. It happens to everyone, to me a bit more often, hehehe. In that kind of battle the factory is the key sector. When the enemies take over the factory, we have 120 seconds to take the factory back, otherwise it reloads 80 points. 30 seconds is locked like any sector, but we still have 1 minute and 30 seconds to recapture. This is situational awareness. The bomber won't do much at the garrison or airfield, but it can recapture the factory in no time. Applause for Mitrejan, he won the battle. Time, 4, rematch. Our recent game, the same map, but a different layout of sectors. In this next fight the plan is similar to the previous battle, only we have other planes, but again the factory is the key sector, and battle is again to 600 points. You know the plan. So I will try to talk less, and show the whole battle. Maybe I will add some music, hehehe. Oh shit, sorry, I accidentally played my Ukrainian playlist. It's not at all true that Azov Battalion is Nazis. XD. Oh, you see there are differences.
Moscow, Empire High.
And here, a small change in the action plan. The fact that we are flying an attack plane does not mean that there will be no dogfight. As you can see, after this unnecessary fight at low HP, we rushed to defend the sector, a key issue, in order to gain air dominance. This time the Bobbers did an ace job, and take over the enemy garrison, and here we have domination over the Golden Knight. Fairly even fight. I chose replays for the film only with top players. Playing against them is always a challenge. One thing is important, I forgot to mention it, if you play in the flight, which I strongly recommend, Remember about the selection of planes. If you play two bombers and you get a map with garrisons and field airfields, you will not have an advantage. Light fighters and heavy fighters are in a better position. Therefore, it is better to mix the types of planes in a flight. Just like in this screenshot from another battle that I doesn't show you. Because, as you can see, our enemies, they play on two light fighters and we play on a bomber and a heavy fighter on a map with a missile base and a command center. This is a significant advantage on our side, without a doubt. To sum up, remember to look at the minimap at any free moment, and be aware of the situation. Play in flight with voice communication on the Discord. Plan your battle taking into account what sectors you are able to take over. Focus on key sectors. Do not unnecessarily defend sectors against bots. The most important thing is capturing sectors. This is the end of this episode. Soon I will do another one on the same topic, because there is a bit more to say in terms of tactics and targeting the right players. Thank you for watching. If you liked, leave a like. Kind regards. See you in the next episode.